Alright, for today's question, it sounds like an advanced calculus question, but you don't need to do anything like that. In fact, you just need algebra. So check this out. We know x and y are greater than 0, and we are going to find the minimum value of x plus 2 over y times y plus 8 over x. How can we even start with it all? We just know x and y are positive numbers. There's no equation relating x and y. Well, you know the deal. Please pause the video and try this first before you watch the solution. Done? Alright, let's have a look. So first, let's just multiply the out and see what happens. So, when we do that, this times this is xy. This times that, the x cancel, it will just be plus 8. This times this will be y cancel, so we have 2. This times this, we have 16 over x times y on the bottom. Now, 8 plus 2 is 10, and then we know x, y are both positive, so we can expect the answer to be bigger than 10, or maybe just 10, I don't know yet. Okay, so how can we continue though? Well, have a look right here. Notice we have the x, y here, and then we also happen to have the x, y on the bottom. In this case, we can try to use the following inequality, and that's the famous AMGM inequality. The AM stands for the arithmetic mean of two numbers, and to do so, let's say we have A and B, we just have to add them up and then divide it by 2. That's how we get the arithmetic mean. Just like if you have $5, you have like $15, 5 plus 15 divided by 2. The average of us, $10 each. So give me the $5 more. But anyways, this arithmetic mean will be greater than or equal to. For the geometric mean, we are going to multiply a and b and then take the square root. Right? This will always be true, and in fact, they will be equal if a is equal to b. Alright? And of course, because the right hand side we have the square root, so we should also mention that a and b should be greater than or equal to 0. Otherwise, square root of a negative number, you get to the imaginary result. So that's not what we want. All right, so how can we utilize this though? I'm going to take this whole thing as our a, and then we'll take this whole thing as the b. Check this out. Xy plus 16 over xy, and then make sure we divide it by 2. So that's the arithmetic mean for this and that. And we know it has to be greater than or equal to the square root of this times that, xy times 16 over xy. Ah, isn't this so nice? That's why I told you, if we have this right here and then the same thing on the bottom, aha, this and that cancel exactly. And as you can see, this expression is equal to square root of 16, which is just equal to 4. Now, 4 is not the number we are going to use, because we care about xy plus 16 over xy. Yeah? This is over 2. So, if you look at this, we can say this implies that xy plus 16 over xy. By multiplying 2 to both sides, we know this will be greater than or equal to 4 times 2, which is equal to 8. And as you can see, this part is always going to be greater than or equal to 8. So that means this right here is the minimum of this 2. So we can go by there and then just do the following. We can say this is going to be greater than or equal to the red part together, let me just connect boxes and that. We can replace that with 8. And of course, 8 plus 2 is 10. So altogether, this right here is equal to 18. So as you can see, this expression is going to be greater than or equal to 18, regardless what x and y are, as long as they are positive. So the answer for this is just equal to 18. And then we're done. Now, I wanted to take some time to prove this inequality for you. And first, let me tell you, all the steps that we are about to do, they are all bidirectional. Meaning, we can start with the first one and go to the next one, and we can also go backwards. They will be true. So, I will just be drawing the bidirectional arrow like this. And in fact, in math, we call this if and only if, which really means if this is true, then this will be true. If this is true, then this has to be true as well. Yeah? So, we start with this. First, let's multiply the positive 2 to both sides, and we can still maintain the inequality. So we have a plus b is greater than or equal to 2 square root of ab. Then, because a and b are non-negative, that means this and that, they will be both non-negative. So we can square both sides without changing the inequality symbol. So this will give us the following, and again, this is if and only if. Let's multiply this out. We get a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. That has to be greater than or equal to 2 squared is 4, square root squared cancel, and we have ab. Then we can just minus 4ab to both sides. So this and that cancel, and we get 0. And again, this will be if and only if. In fact, you can just either draw the arrow or write down IFF. You don't need to do both. I don't know why I'm doing both, but anyways. We are going to get a squared, and that will be a minus 2ab plus b squared, and that's greater than or equal to 0. And finally, I will just factor the left-hand side. So, draw the arrow, or if you like, put down IFF, or maybe do both. Here we get a minus b squared, and that is still, of course, greater than or equal to 0. And in fact, we are done. So we can draw a box and shade it in to symbolically represent that we are done with the proof. Because on the left-hand side, we have a square, and the square can never be negative. So we are saying this is non-negative, which is, of course, true. Now, little note on the side real quick. Well, if you want to have the equal sign, a plus b over 2 is equal to square root of ab, this right here is true if a is equal to b. Why? Because you can see that right here. If a and b are equal, when you subtract them, you get 0. 0 squared is equal to 0. So that's the case when they are equal. So that's it.